Dear customers, dear audience, my name is Oliver Gühring, and I would like to warmly welcome you to TechLight 2021. It's great that you are taking part again, even though the majority of you will be here for the first time, since this year we're not only broadcasting in German-speaking countries, but also worldwide. Last year, all the trade fairs were cancelled. We had to find a way of informing you about our new products. We wanted this to be as personal as possible, and this is how we came up with the concept of TechLight, a digital trade fair. Here, our product managers present the latest products and services almost as if you had visited the trade fair in person. Of course, today we all know that no digital format can replace personal contact. But TechLight 2020 was well received. The products and topics are still up to date, and I can only recommend that you take a look at TechLight 2020. We have meanwhile added a voiceover in English, and you can find it on our homepage. But enough advertising for TechLight 2020, let's talk about this year's TechLight. Of course, we have innovations to present this year too. But above all, we have been thinking about what you could benefit from most. That is how we came up with the topic of milling. It affects almost everyone, and the process offers incredible optimization potential. This year, we not only want to present our new milling cutter, the RF100 Sharp, but also discuss with our product experts how the entire milling process can be optimized. The roundtable discussion will be chaired by Dr. Beer from our Research and Development Department. And that's it from me by way of introduction. Should you have any requests or suggestions regarding our digital communication, I would of course be delighted to hear from you. Or simply tell me personally when we see each other at a real trade fair. I would like to thank you very much for watching. Above all, I hope you learnt something new today. And now hand over to Dr. Beer. I wish you every success and all the best.
Dear customers, dear audience, I too would like to welcome you to this year's TechLight 2021 with the motto, Milling to the Limit. Together with my four colleagues, I would like to discuss which milling applications are possible today and how to get the most out of them. That brings me to my first question. Milling up to the limit? First of all, where is the limit?
The limit is very individual. This always depends on which boundary conditions exist, which machines and systems we are using, and which clamping situations we have. The complete machining process can only ever be as stable as the weakest link in the drive chain. If, for example, we now have a relatively weak lathe with little drive power, then we reach the limit, even with relatively low parameters. However, if we have an optimum machine with a high drive output, above all a high degree of rigidity, good tool holders, and the entire process is optimal together with the correctly selected tool, then we can achieve maximum machining volumes up to the limit. And the good news is that no matter what machine or clamping conditions, we are able to push closer to the limit. And that's why we developed this tool, our new RF100 Sharp Solid Carbide Cutter.
Impressive images. So now we've seen a lot of chips and a wide range of applications. Mr. Erler, what exactly was the limit here that the RF100 Sharp might have defined or even exceeded?
Yes, first of all you have to consider that our users are under cost pressure and are therefore forced to mill faster and faster. They must move the limit up higher and higher. There is not much else they can do. And to get back to your question, what have we seen here? Firstly, we have selected our new solid carbide milling cutter RF100 Sharp. Secondly, we are using the Torchoy dynamic milling strategy. And thirdly, the corresponding high cutting parameters, which then enable this performance. With regard to the machine, we have an extremely dynamic high-speed machine here. Of course, this machine is not as resilient to the cutting forces. And that's why, with our new, sharp solid carbide milling cutter, we are able to operate at low cutting force in order to protect the machine. The RF100 Sharp Solid Carbide Milling Cutter is characterized by its sharp cutting edges and is therefore particularly kind on the machine. Here, we can see a 30,000 spindle with HSK50, where we have selected lateral feed to 8% of the milling cutter diameter, and this makes these high cutting parameters possible, namely the cutting speed VC over 350 meters per minute. The feeds per tooth we use here are 0.2 millimeters per tooth, which means that we achieve the highest cutting volumes up to the limit.
When we talk about the limit region, it is not only the tool that should be considered. Rather, we must take a holistic view of the machining, for example, of the machine, clamping situation, tool holder, tool, and machining strategy. Especially when milling up to the limit, we have to take a closer look at the interface between the machine's spindle and the tool, in other words, the tool holder. The tool holder must have a few basic properties such as high rigidity, very high clamping forces, and good damping properties. Most tool holders, such as ER collet chuck adapters or shrink chucks, only fulfill these properties in isolated cases. That's why we recommend using our HPC power chuck to solve the problem. With the HPC power chuck, the tool is clamped by a clamping sleeve via a mechanical worm gear in the holder. As a result, the tool is clamped with very high clamping forces, and at the same time we have the highest rigidity and damping properties thanks to the clamping sleeves, and thus all properties required for milling up to the limit are fulfilled.
But Mr. Herzog, in order to arrive at the HPC power chuck as the solution to the problem, I first have to recognize the problem and also narrow it down to being the clamping fixture. The fact that I have a problem is usually recognizable relatively quickly. The machine wails and rattles, or the component does not achieve the desired quality. But first narrowing down where the problem lies is much more difficult. How can I tell them that I'm close to the limit?
You are right, Dr. Beer. Often it's not obvious what's wrong. For this reason, the process should be analyzed during machining. This allows you to identify the problem more quickly, fix it more quickly, and perhaps even prevent it from happening at all. We are successful in the field of services, and especially in the field of software. For many years now, we have been constantly developing the GTMS, Gühring Tool Management Software. A new module of the Gühring Machine Control Center, GMCC, can process data in addition to providing information on machine state, magazine monitoring, and MDE functionality. When the customer connects their machine to the software receives a wide variety of machine data, such as the drive capacity or spindle power, throughout, so that we can see relatively precisely when the machine reaches the limit or when the point is reached where we have to intervene, in order to achieve a machine-friendly process.
Yes, but to reach the performance limit of a machine that uses the entire machine, everything really has to be okay. I need to have selected the right chuck, selected the right tool, have the right component on the machine, and of course, the component must be correctly clamped. Everything's just right and you can really push the machine to the limit. But I don't think that's often the case. Let's take lathe as an example. If I want to use the sharp on a lathe, what do I do? Do you already have experience here?
Yes, of course. Special situations exist on lathes. This means that the tool is usually mounted on a live tool, on a so-called driven tool, on the turret. We have various limits there. For example, the speed is very limited. Due to the small bearing, the rigidity is also very limited. And the collet chuck adapter, which is often integrated into the system, does not exactly offer any great benefits. And therefore, it is extremely important on the lathe that we have very low cutting forces. But we also need to look at the tool and the workpiece side of things. On the workpiece side, we often have an interfering contour due to the jaw chunk. This means that the workpiece must be further unclamped, and it is also very important here that we apply limited cutting forces to the workpiece. And it is precisely here that the RF100 sharp is the right choice, because in addition to the easy cutting factor, we also have the option of selecting the tool in a smaller size due to the increased cutting length, which then suits the machine much better and exerts lower forces on the workpiece. With reduced cutting parameters, we have a long contact time, creating high temperatures. From the coating side, we have applied an extremely resistant layer, which is thermally and chemically very stable. All in all, we are therefore able to significantly increase the output on the lathe and thus achieve an optimum limit here.
So now we have the upper limit, but as you already said, the speed is limited on certain lathes, and the smaller the tool becomes, the more critical the speed becomes to achieve a sufficient cutting speed at all. Mr. Seeker, what about using micro-tools for lathes? How can we perform with micro-tools under such conditions?
Yes, that's right, Mr. Beer. Speed is often the problem. Customers do not always have the option of achieving high cutting speeds with their machinery, even for the smallest diameters. Many features, such as feather key grooves, micro-flanging radii, or similar, often still need to be incorporated into the components. Our solution here is the micro-diver. Although this tool was developed for the high-end range, it is also ideal for low speeds. For our customers, this means they can also achieve high feeds and high infeeds. However, as already indicated, with micro tools we can also extend the limit to the maximum by selecting the right tool. In concrete terms, this means that we can achieve feed and cutting values with the micro diver that were previously not possible for micro tools. For the customer, this means that under good conditions, they can use this tool for 2XD full grooves with process reliability. By choosing the right tool, we can also extend the limit for micro tools. We can guarantee optimum performance both at low speeds and on modern, high-speed machines. As already indicated, the entire framework conditions must be right for optimum machining in the milling area. Optimum clamping, a perfect machine, the right tool, and the right tool holder.
High-speed machines in combination with micro-tools are a good keyword, because we are talking about speeds of 30,000 RPM and higher. At these speeds, it is recommended to use tool holders that are completely rotationally symmetrical. The rotational symmetry reduces the residual imbalances of the tool holder to a minimum. It protects the machine spindle and ensures a smooth machining result. However, it is also important here that the clamping fixture, in other words the tool holder, has the best possible properties, such as high concentric accuracy, high clamping forces, and good damping properties. Specifically for our micro tools, we recommend the use of our new, completely rotationally symmetrical precision collet chuck adapters, which optimally combine all these properties. And by using optionally sealed collet chucks for internal cooling or normal collet chucks for peripheral cooling, the system can be perfectly adapted to the corresponding tools, in other words, our micro tools.
So we've talked a lot about solutions, or heard a lot about solutions, but usually it's all about, I have a problem and need to solve it, but I don't know how. At the very beginning, I'm usually at the machine. I have a tool, my holder, and my process, but then, for example, cutting data is missing. Silly question, Mr. Stump, but how do I get cutting data?
That's not a problem at all, Dr. Beer. As usual, the customer can get in touch with their contact persons from sales, the application engineer, or field staff. However, they can also use the digital channels for support purposes. For example, they can use the additional service hotline. They can use WhatsApp. They can use the chat. And don't worry, there will always be someone on the other side. We don't work with a bot. But if they do not have a personal contact person, they are also able to retrieve cutting data for a processing task, for example, quickly and easily, by using our Gühring Navigator. After entering the relevant information, the customer receives a tool recommendation and the corresponding cutting data in this product finder. And if they use the shop, they can also download the cutting data here when filling the shopping basket. If they now have a tool in the drawer, want to use it for a new work task, and are not sure whether they can use this tool, they can use the reverse search in the navigator. There, they check the suitability and also the cutting data. If required, they can also generate and download a data sheet for everything.
Okay, so now I've got the right tool from the navigator, I have the right cutting conditions, I'm on the machine, but it doesn't work. This is a typical problem that everyone has encountered. Now let's take a look at such a problem.
Here you can see this well. The customer has selected the right tool, in this case a 16mm sharp milling cutter, and they also have used the correct cutting data. And still, the tool does not run optimally under these conditions. The 16mm cutter, although very soft cutting, is significantly superior to the machine. That's why we have the corresponding rattling noises, and we don't have a reliable process. This is the reason why we chose the 10mm sharp, which, with its cutting length, is still sufficient for this component application, and as a result, we were able to significantly reduce these cutting forces, because we can also operate with higher parameters and higher speeds. We have adapted the cutting strategy. This means that we can also achieve a corresponding increase in performance on this simple machine and can significantly extend the limit upwards. And the customer also saves a lot of money with this smaller tool.
Mr. Ehler, we should also note that in the application shown, contrary to the general recommendation, the tool holder was changed from an ER collet chuck adapter to our newly developed superline hydraulic expansion chuck with reducing bushing. Now, you could say hydraulic expansion chuck and milling, that doesn't go together, but it does, thanks to the short and compact design of the superline hydraulic expansion chuck and the use of reducing bushes, a very high clamping force can be achieved and good rigidity achieved, which is why milling is also possible with these tool holders. Another advantage is the easy and excellent operation combined with the very good damping properties usual for hydraulic expansion chucks. The use of reducing bushes is important for milling. Thus, the transferable torque from the tool holder to the tool shank can be increased further and the limit can be shifted.
Here it also becomes apparent that I can only shift the limit if everything is really coordinated and the process is perfect. And depending on which industry I'm in, it's all the more important that everything fits. Let's take medical engineering, for example. Legal regulations also need to be complied with here, which further increases the requirements on processes. Or am I mistaken?
We have been serving customers in the medical engineering sector for many years, and you are absolutely right. The demands of customers and users in this sector are constantly growing. In order to meet these demands, we are investing heavily in this area. Apart from taking on additional specialists, we have opened a test field in Wehingen, near our company headquarters, and also near the medical area of Tuttlingen, where we can support customers in this sector even better.
And in this test field for medical engineering, we now have the opportunity to offer our customers process optimization as well as feasibility studies in the 3- and 5-axis range. And, as micromachining plays an increasingly important role in medical engineering in particular, our new product, the MicroDiver, scores highly here. Let's take a look at the applications. Here, the limit values are available in a large number. We mill delicate components on very unstable clampings, using very small tools. Our customers expect a maximum machining volume, because in this industry in particular, components such as bone plates or surgical instruments are generally milled from one piece.
Yes, Mr. Seeker is right, especially in medical engineering, where we have these high strength and high alloyed and tough materials, and also these delicate contours. It is particularly important that they are very easy to cut. Moreover, we have to take into account that the batch sizes in medical engineering are becoming even smaller. Unlike the past, where you worked on forged blanks, now we have the situation where deliveries are made on demand in even smaller quantities. Components are now milled from a single piece. This means that you have minimally clamped a workpiece of flat material and then have to mill the component from one piece. And this is precisely where our RF100 Sharp excels. This easy cutting tool reduces these forces, which is ideal for these materials. This means that we are then able to machine these medical components much faster. This means shorter processing times through the correct choice of tool during roughing.
And in addition to the RF100 Sharp, the micro diver also helps to shorten processing times. Let's take a look at the case of a bone plate, for example. Shallow bores, countersinks, or feather key grooves, or even pilot bores can be produced with this tool without the need for another tool. Thanks to its effective peripheral cooling, it can also master these difficult applications reliably and without problems in these difficult-to-machine materials.
May I interrupt? Of course, coordinating test fields, feasibility studies and parameters works very well for large-scale production or when installed for my process. But Mr. Erler, you just said the quantities are getting smaller and personalized medicine quantity 1 is theoretically the goal here. This means that the customer has placed the component on the machine and now needs a solution if they have a problem. What then?
Dr. Beer, with over 900 sales representatives worldwide, we try to provide personal support on site if necessary. Last year has shown that we could no longer offer this personal service from one day to the next. We had to rethink things such as how can we provide our customers with the usual service when problems arrive if we are not allowed to be on site. The solution is a new live video support tool with which the customer can take our experts to the machine. In other words, if the customer has contacted us via call, chat, or WhatsApp, then our technician will get in touch with the customer. And with the help of an app and the customer's smartphone, our technician can analyze the problem as if they were on site. In addition to the camera function, this tool also offers other functions, which is why it differs significantly from the normal video chat tools we are already familiar with. You can mark things in color. You can draw symbols. You can also include a drawing so that you can discuss the problem together in an efficient way. And the customer only shows what they really want. And that's how we provide technical support when the customer needs it. Fast, contactless, and efficient.
With all these options, it should be possible to solve everyone's individual problem. We have now spent quite a long time talking about problems and solutions. Thank you very much for all your input and interesting conversations. But now let me return to my initial question. Where is the limit? The limit is redefined for each application. For each application, the limits must be redetermined in order to be able to shift them. And it doesn't matter if I'm on an unstable lathe with the micro diver or on a large machining center with the RF100 Sharp. It is always important to see the process as a whole in order to be able to select the right tools. This can also be a digital tool, such as the GMCC, or a clamping fixture specifically adapted to the application. And now I'd like to thank you for your time and attention, and cordially invite you to TechLight 2021 at techlight.gohring.com. There you will find more detailed information on all the topics discussed, which just leads me to say, get in touch with us, so that we can also define your limits and move them upwards.